Hello guys, this is Sushil from Sushil Cinema, and today I'm starting this tutorial series of how we can start with a 3D model, and after that how to animate that in a perfect way as of an industrial format, how they actually do the lip syncing and as well as the body rigging, and how exactly one 3D model goes from one step to from one starting with modeling, we can say. But here I'm using zbrush for sculpting, because the kind of model I'm doing today is kind of creature kind of thing, but it is cute creature kind of thing. So I'm using GSPS, which is already there in project folder. One of our model was there already in project folder. I just picked up that and just adjusted the pose I wanted to, and then just converted it into in a normal polygon way. But keep this in mind, but whenever you convert using Control A, it's a Control A is a key to convert that. So that you can sculpt. Once you convert, the first thing I think, actually I prefer that, is to make the whole model in one polygroup, because when you use GSPS, there are so many polygroups for for different part of our body. There are different polygroups will be there, so you need to create one polygroup and after that just start sculpting. So I just adjusted the model and then started. I'm not a regular sculptor, and this I just wanted to start with an easy way, because I don't wanted to take any 3D free 3D model from from online or somewhere and then start, because I just wanted to start everything from the scratch. So basically the main intention was like how exactly when you sculpt also, and after that when you take that model for the retopology, so what is the main the standard the type of retopology you have to do for the animation level, to get the clean animation. So how exactly the topology formats are like the standards animators maintain. Okay, so this is not this tutorial is not exactly for the experts and all. So this is for the intermediate guys who I regularly try to do something on zbrush as well as Maya, but somewhere they get stuck, and somewhere they just wanted to follow the steps, okay, from start to finish. So exactly I have tried in so many different tutorials. I just wanted to find something which is completely raw, because like it should start from one place and then it should end like a complete ready product or something. But unfortunately, like some of the tutorials which I got is like very high end, and then they are just completely breaked into so many parts and all. But it's okay, but somehow I didn't get something like starting with the sculpt model, the raw things and not something. Okay, so if somebody was like explaining on rigging, then they just are they are just using some example models from some online stuff or something, and then they are doing. So I just wanted to use everything in a raw way. So I just wanted to make a model by myself, and then just if I need to retopology, because every time what happens in a biggest movies and all, so the concept art they start with the concept art. Okay, they start with the concept art, then the normal paint or drawing or something of that particular model or some or creature, if we can say, then after that they that thing needs to be sculpt in a zbrush, okay, which is again the industry level software. Then there are so many details they just use to create the high quality models. Okay, but I'm here just for the example purpose. I'm just making this model, and I'm not concerning or giving more time for this thing. So I as I said, I'm not a regular ZBrush guy, but I really wanted to start the daily basis sessions because I'm missing so much this artwork because of some other works. So I need to start so that I can go more clean and clear and more in detail way. So here also I'm not just bothering about so much of details. I just wanted to follow some of anatomy of a human, just the shape of that body or something, and then I'm just sculpting a normal basic format. Okay, so I think you have understood what I'm saying, what I'm trying to say. So just also whenever you are working on such things, try to save the work. Okay, it is very 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 important, because anytime working in between these kind of softwares may crash, and then but in ZBrush there is a very I can say there's a good option, like a quick save is there. So from that folder you can just retrieve your work. So even working on this model also, it happened, and then I just retrieved from quick save, and then I started again. So basically you should when you do work on ZBrush, try to understand the different type of brushes and the use of brushes. So let me tell you about this process actually. So I started it an early morning, I think. Actually in midnight I had started this work, and then I thought of just starting it and then holding it back, but while working, I don't know, I was so much of I got so much of interest in this, so I just continued. Once I finished this, and I started with Maya, and then I started retopologizing this. See, the thing is, like, at first when I started working on ZBrush and this Maya and all, so I was searching for some sort of shortcuts. What I mean, like, I thought, like, once I finished sculpting and polypainting, usually I do polypainting in ZBrush only, so I don't use, till now I didn't use Photoshop and something, like, I just when I finished sculpting, then I started with polypainting, and after that I retrieved the textures from ZBrush itself. So at first I was having what we can say, that not complete knowledge on this. So I was thinking, like, okay, once we complete this sculpting, we can directly take the model using this gauze, is that gauzy, you can say, like, using that option I used to take the model from ZBrush to Maya directly, and then I used to start rigging. Okay, so at first I didn't know rigging also, but then advanced skeleton 5 It was like when it came, then I started working on that. I started learning that, and once I did, then first, as I told, like I used to take the models directly from here to Maya, and then directly starting rigging, and then try to animate that. But one thing I came to know, that like there is a process. Okay, so this is a different kind of process that the industry follows, you know, a kind of process which need to be followed. Okay, it is there is no shortcut things. Okay, usually when I came to like know about the zbrush, like G remesher, also like usually I when we start sculpting, we use dynamesh. So for high quality and details and all, we use dynamesh, and after that then we go with the G remesher, like for, you know, automatic retopology concept, that like we use G remesher in ZBrush. So it creates chords, and it was very good. But I was like, at first I used to think like, okay, when we just convert that whole the sculpt model in G remesher, then definitely we lose so many details from that. Then I started I came to know like, okay, there is a projection concept is there, okay, where from dynamesh models details can be projected on the G remesh model. So then that was also okay, but still the number of chords and the vertices are definitely heavy when we take the models from here, from ZBrush to Maya. So basically I came to know, like, okay, G remesh we can do, and we can just reduce the number of polygons here, and then we can take out, then it might be okay for animations. But the kind of animations we can do is like the animations which might not need any lip syncing or facial expressions. So then I came to know that, okay, so there is a concept called retopology. I usually try to avoid those things. Retopology, I don't wanted to enter into that thing, because I find it very tough for me, like, okay, god, like how to do the whole body retopology thing. So when we already worked on model, using so much of time, and again reworking on the same thing, it's like putting the dress or something on that particular model, using retopology or something. So that was like kind of, I felt crucial. Okay, so because of that, I almost started working on these models, on this 3D softwares and all, from almost 6 to 7 months, I can say, but yeah, so many steps I used to avoid. Okay, so go or dig into those things, and I used to avoid the different terminologies or things, like, okay, where there is a lip sync, or facial facial animation or something. So because if you just avoid those things, then the whole body that kind of animation that can be done by just G remeshing the sculpt. Because usually you're doing the same thing, like you're just reducing the polygons and then just taking the same model over there. First I was like having issues with applying the textures, like when we poly paint here, and then how, and then there are so many. See, when you start working on these things, there is a need for each and every step, because you are a first timer and you need to know so many, you know, terminologies and technologies at the same time, or, you know, there are so many steps. You will get lost, okay, when you start, okay, so somewhere you will get stuck, and then you might find it hard to come out from that, or you might lose the interest and you will stop. The same thing happened with me, okay, which happened with me like this. I used to lose the interest because somewhere in between, while working, because when I sculpted the first model, it was like against kind of a, you know, creature is it, that is my, you know, kind of a passion of working on, you know, VFX, or, you know, that kind of models, you know, that horrific things and horror models and something. So when I worked on that, I didn't bother about this number of chords, vertices, and this number of polygons. Basically, number of polygons. I didn't bother about that. I just blindly, you know, sculpted the model using the highest quality, and then I just took the same quality model from ZBrush to Maya. So at that time it was so hard to explore in Maya that, like, Maya is like completely stopped working, okay, you can say. But even though if it is working, it was like working like in very, you know, very slow, because definitely the size of a file and you know, the model which having the huge number of polygons will make the Maya, you know, a little dizzy. So definitely it will stop working. So see, these are the these are the terminologies. Like for beginners, we don't go through by all these steps. But let me clear you this. Like if you spend some time on this, and if you just practice like on at least 5 to 10 different models, I think that is the most wonderful the thing you are doing. Because once you spend the time for each and every step, working on each and every step, basically you can take like a week for rigging, okay? So this week we'll do only rigging and something on different models. So first, if you want, you can just take different models from internet, so you will get so many 3D models from internet. Try to learn the kind of topology they use in all the models. So if you want to understand the techniques while creating the topology, a kind of topology you need for animations and the expressions and the lip syncing, okay, so that is completely different, and it is standard, okay, there is a standard, okay, you can't avoid that standard. There is a standard, and you must have to use the same standard throughout while retopology of the model. So you can't just use z-remeshed model directly from what we can say from ZBrush to Maya, and then so it might work or it might not, okay, sometimes. So that is the thing, okay, so but most of the time it will not work. So as everything uses some standards, so definitely you must have to go with that standard. So if you fail using that, and then there will be reworks. And as we know, you will learn from the mistakes, which is a standard term. So and for doing mistakes, you need to work first. So that is the important thing. So when you work, then only you will understand exactly what is happening. Most of the time, what will happen, like, okay, so I'm not getting this, okay, I just want to quit, that's it. So most of the people, like, they start working on something, and then they say, like, okay, no, it is not happening in my in the way which I wanted, and so I just want to stop. So this will not work. The first thing is, like, in 3D world, like, in this industry, you need so much of patience, and patience actually pays here. Now this is not something like, you know, kind of cold thing or something like which we you can learn and then just take some you know bit of code from here and there and you place in something and then you like complete the whole project or something. No, this is not like that. I am actually a developer too, so I used to develop websites as well as softwares. So every time I used to seek for, you know, some shortcuts in while coding, okay, and I usually used to get those things. While working on these objects also, I tried so much. I'm at the while starting, you know, at first I tried so much, but no, this is now if you can see what I'm doing, it is the result of almost a year. Okay, so basically, like, seriously, I started working on this from last 3 months. On each and every terms, but I'm in touch with these softwares from almost a year or two. So I just happen to you know, visit this and do some work here and there, some small work, some renders, you know, then some VFX. I used to use Blender first, so I used Blender for compositing some VFX things. And the most probably, as I said, I used to be in a I used to be a coder. Then I used to use, you know, internet more oftenly. Okay, so I use so much of surfing internet and everything. So I used to take, you know, so many different models or creatures from here and there, and then used to start compositing those things in. On the real-time videos, like, I used to shoot, because the main theme of my channel is to, like, filming, okay, so learn how to film. So that definitely includes the camera work, and then this cinematography and this filming, you know, different kind of videos and all. So we used to have, you know, different VFX scenes and all. So I used to take different models and then used to compose it. So guys, this is the final product actually. I haven't you know, started painting, poly painting, because now I just wanted to retopologize this. Okay, let's see in next video.